In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a premium animated title in After Effects, so let's get to it. First, I'll create a new composition. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, 10 seconds for the duration. Click OK. Then select the type tool and type something. Let's go for animated. For the font, I'm using Montserrat Black with a size of 150 pixels in all caps. Then I'll open the align tab and align the text in the center of the composition. Then I'll select it here so it's highlighted. Go into Edit, Duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. I'll bring the duplicated text layer down, double click on it, and type a second word, so title, then click away. And here we have two words, each one is in a separate text layer, and we can separately animate them. But before we start animating, let's properly position the text layers. First, let's select the selection tool, then click here and enable title action safe so we can see the center point. Zoom into the composition using the mouse wheel, select the first word, and drag it up above this like horizontal central line like that, and select the second word and bring it down like this. So position the text layers in such a way that there's still some space between them. Okay, once you've done that, make sure you're not selecting any text layers, so click away. Then select the rectangle tool, click on the word fill, set it to a solid color. The actual color doesn't matter. Click on the word stroke, set it to none. Then zoom out slightly and create a rectangle covering the bottom half of the composition like that. Then zoom in, and you can, using the arrow keys, precisely align this horizontal line so it covers exactly the half of the composition. So like that. Once you've done that, we can hide the visibility of the shape layer by toggling the eye icon. Let's also disable the title action save. We don't need them anymore. Let's open effects and presets window and search for set matte effect and add it to both text layers. Then head over to the effect controls and we want to set take matte from layer, shape layer 1 for both text layers. And for the word that is above, the first one, we need to enable invert matte so we can see it. And here we can see both text layers again and we can start animating them. So I'm going to expand the properties of the first word, click the animate button, select position. Then you will see the add button, click on it, property tracking. And here I'm going to set the second position value to something like 120, works fine in my case. This could be different depending on the size of the font that you're using, so play around with the value. And for the tracking, I'll set it to negative 100, so the all letters are bunched together like that. Then make sure the time indicator is at the start of the timeline. Expand the range selector 1 and create a keyframe for start at 0%. Move 2 seconds forward and set start to 100%. Then drag and select the keyframes, right-click any of them, keyframe assistant, easy, or you can press F9 as a shortcut. Then while the keyframes are selected, go into the graph editor, right-click, make sure edit speed graph is selected, then drag and select the first point, you'll see the yellow handles, drag them all the way in to create this peak in the middle, and exit the graph editor, and here is the animation, very, very snappy. Now we want to copy this animation to the second word as well, and here we need to select the animator one, so it's highlighted, press Ctrl C to copy it, move the time indicator to the start of the timeline, and select the second word, press Ctrl V to paste the same animation here. We need to open the properties, text, animator 1, and we need to set the position of it to negative 120, so the text comes from top to bottom, so like that. And if we preview this, you can see both text layers are animating at the same time. If that is the look you want to go for, it is completely fine. I prefer to offset the animation so they animate different times. For that, I'm going to select both text layers, press U on the keyboard to see the keyframes. Move the time indicator to 15 frames, select the second word keyframes and offset them to 15 frames. So now if you preview this, you can see that the text layers are like animating at different times and that looks nice. Here I'm going to add a secondary animation by adding a null object. So layer, new null object. Let's position it above all layers like that, then drag and select all layers except the null and parent them using this parent pick whip. Drag it and drop it onto the null one, then select the null one and press S to bring up scale. Let's move to 1 second, 15 frames, and create a keyframe for scale. Let's move 2 seconds forward from here to 3 seconds, 15 frames. Set scale to 90%. Then drag and select the keyframes. Press F9 to ease them. Open the graph editor and do the same thing with the graph. Drag all the both handles all the way in to create this peak in the middle. Exit the graph editor. And before we preview, let's enable motion blur. If you don't see this colon, click toggle switches and mode until you do and enable motion blur for both text layers. Also make sure this one is blue so you can see the motion blur. And if we preview this, this is the kind of animation that we'll get. Very nice and smooth. And here, let's add an adjustment layer. Layer, new adjustment layer. Let's search for transforming effects and presets. Add it to the adjustment layer. Then in effect controls, set skew to -8 degrees, or just -8 to skew the whole animation. And here we can do the preview again. You can see it looks very, very nice and snappy. And we have the in animation, though we can see the text and there's no out animation. So let's easily create one. First, let's drag and select all layers, right click any of them, pre-compose. And let's call this one title, click OK. Then open this pre-comp. Press U on the keyboard and go to the last frame, or the last keyframe of the null object, should be this one at 3 seconds, 15 frames. Press N, then hover over this area, work area, right click, select trim comp to work area, then go back to the render composition, and this precomp should be trimmed, as you can see. I'm going to select it and press Ctrl D to duplicate it, and move it forward in such a way that once the first one finishes, the second one continues, then right click on the second one, time reverse layer, and here if we do the preview, we'll see that we have the in animation, that we can see the text for a while, and then it slowly animates out in a similar way. And this is the complete animated title, as you can see, and in terms of customizing it, it is very easy to do. Open the title precomp, and you can change the color of individual text layers using the character window. You can change the font, the size, and even type out different words. So let's say motion and the second one, graphics. And once you get back to the render composition, you can see everything is automatically adjusted. And you can use this as a template for various scenarios. And that is it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.